Today, in Questions That Matter, we're asking, should Christians fear the tribulation to come? Here's John Ecob from the Herald of Hope.
The main reason that we need not fear the tribulation is because we have the promise of God that we won't be here. And if I can trust God's word about my eternal salvation, I can certainly trust his promise that I won't be here for the great tribulation. And the scripture is very clear about this. In the book of Revelation in chapter 3 and in verse 10, we read this, "Because thou hast kept the word of my patience, I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation, which shall come upon all the world to try them that dwell upon the earth." He said, "Behold, I come quickly." The Lord Jesus promised to those who are overcomers. Now, the word overcomer in John's gospel and his epistle and in the book of Revelation refers to people who know Christ as their personal saviour. Every child of God is an overcomer. It's not just victorious Christians. It's every believer. Whosoever is born of God overcometh the world. Who is he that overcometh the world but he that believeth that Jesus is the Son of God? And so here the Lord Jesus is promising, "I will keep thee from the hour of temptation which shall come upon all the world." He doesn't say, "I will keep you from the trouble of the tribulation." He's saying, "I will keep you from the time of tribulation, the very hour." So therefore, the Christian can rest assured that I will not be here for that time of great tribulation. But that's not the only scripture. If we turn over to the epistle of Paul to the Thessalonians and chapter 4 and 5, we have a description of the rapture of the church in chapter 4. The Apostle Paul says, "The Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel and the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord." Now that's the rapture, the catching away of the Christians. But then he goes on to chapter 5, and in the original Greek manuscripts, there were no chapter divisions. They've been added to help us to memorize scripture. We can read straight on from chapter 4 into chapter 5. And it says, "The times and the seasons, brethren, ye have no need that I write unto you." Now he's talking about the rapture, and he says, "Now when will it happen?" And he says, "For yourselves know perfectly that the day of the Lord so cometh as a thief in the night." Now, the day of the Lord, right through Scripture, refers to God's judgment on the world. At various times in history, God has poured out his judgment upon nations, and he's going to pour out his judgment in the last days, and it's the day of the Lord when God will rise up to judge the wicked world in which we live. And so he says, "The day of the Lord so cometh as a thief in the night." People won't expect it. You don't expect a thief to come. He comes when you don't expect him. And so the day of the Lord will come when people are not expecting it. "And when they shall say, peace and safety, then sudden destruction cometh upon them as travail upon a woman with child, and they shall not escape." You know, when a woman is pregnant and she's about to have a baby, she can't change her mind. It is irrevocable. She will have that baby. It's on its way. And God's judgment will be on its way when the trumpet sounds and the rapture takes place. And so we read then, "But you, brethren, are not in darkness that day," what day? The day of the Lord. "That day should overtake you as a thief." So he's saying the Christians won't be overtaken by the day of the Lord, because we won't be here. And in verse 9, he goes on to reassure us, "For God hath not appointed us to wrath, but to obtain salvation by our Lord Jesus Christ." Now, the word salvation there simply means deliverance. And it's talking about the wrath of the day of the Lord. Now, this is not the wrath of hell. This is the wrath of the day of the Lord. The context here is the day of the Lord. He's not talking about eternal judgment. He's talking about the judgment that God is going to send upon this world, the day of the Lord. And so he says, God has not appointed us Christians to wrath, the wrath of the day of the Lord, but to obtain deliverance, salvation, by our Lord Jesus Christ, who died for us, that whether we wake or sleep, we should live together with him. Wherefore, comfort yourselves together and edify one another, even as also you do. You know, it's a great comfort for the Christian to know that we won't be here for the Great Tribulation. The rapture is going to take place first, and we're going to be caught up to meet the Lord in the air with all of the loved ones who have gone before. What a meeting that's going to be in the heavens, the clouds of angels around about us, and we're going to rejoice in his presence forevermore.